Folks, just arrived?
Yes. We're looking for 5048 and a half.
Here, darn suit. A nice cozy little place with an extra wall bed. But it's 55 and a half.
No, you don't understand. We're looking for Mrs. Barton.
Barton! Of all people!
Well,
here you go. Why didn't you folks let us know you were coming? I almost swooned when I heard you yelling.
I wasn't yelling. This old parcel here...
This is Mr. Sliscomb, our landlord.
How do you do?
Yes, it is.
This is my daughter, Helen.
You hired her not in the middle of the day.
Where's Willie?
Yes, where is Willie? Where's the kid?
Why, Willie's asleep.
Asleep at 11 o'clock in the morning? What's the matter? Does he work at night?
No, but you see, Willie's...
Come on, Ma. Let's go wake him.
Bob.
Okay.
First trip to California?
Yeah.
Mighty pretty country.
Sure is. I suppose you're a native son.
Yep. Too much of it. Burns up the grass.
Oh,
everybody.
is your business?
I'm a director.
A director?
An assistant director.
Well, how long has it been since you've had a call from the studio?
6 weeks.
Of course, I have to prepare for my next assignment.
Any reason why you shouldn't be earning a living?
No, of course not, but...
Okay, listen. You better come along with me. We'll hire a car and take a look at some of those farms.
But, Bob, the phone!
Well, if you haven't had a call from the studio for 6 weeks, I think maybe you can take an afternoon off.
But... Hello? This is Willie Barton speaking. Oh, Miss Brown. All right, Miss Brown, I'll have Mother... I'll speak to her about it. I said I'd speak to her about it. All right, Mr. Brown. Now we'll have Mother send it over to you right away. Thank you, Mr. Brown. That was Mr. Brown.
Who's Mr. Brown?
Why, he's the grocery man.
What does he want sent over?
We forgot to pay.
You forgot to? What's the matter? Didn't you get my check this month?
Why, yes, of course, Bob. But Willie needed a new pair of riding boots.
Riding boots? I send money out here every month for food and rent, and you spend it on riding boots for him. Huh. Well, that settles,
Bob. You yell.
I yell if I want to. Young man, you come along with me. Never mind. I'll answer. Probably the butcher. Hello? Well, no, this is his brother-in-law. You, studio. Hello?
This is Agatha, Willie. I have to search for a minute to tell you that the big scene comes off tomorrow. And if you get down here right away, you might get on to help handle the crowd.
All right, I'll be right down.
That's fine, Willie. But hurry. Goodbye.
All right, I won't quibble then. Let's say $100 a day. Okay, goodbye. Sorry, Bob, I can't go with you. I'd better help you out some other time.
Yeah, well, don't forget your riding boots.
$100 a day. Isn't it exciting?
Yeah, well, I'll be able to control myself until I see that $100. Say, come on, get your hat on. We're going to look at some of those farms.
Oh, I'm sorry, Bob. I've got a terrible headache.
Well, let you and I go, Mother, huh?
I'd like to, but I've got to cook Willie's dinner.
Say, what's the matter with everybody, huh? Oh, I got to go by myself. Huh. You people should feel right at home on a nut farm.
But you had a headache.
I have, but I think the air will do me good.
Air? That Bob was right.
School racket's all right. But if some pupils don't turn up soon, I'll have to go back waiting tables at the embassy.
I don't know what excuse I'm going to give my hotel. I've exhausted all the old ones.
When will you boys realize that it's always darkest just before the dawn? Any moment, opportunity may knock.
Who's that?
Opportunity.
No, opportunity only knocks once. Come in.
Are you Hamilton T. Holland?
Yes, what can I do for you?
We're from the Globe Furniture Company.
Wait a minute. You, just a minute. I was with you. I'll settle this. Just a moment.
All right, Joe.
Hello. Globe Furniture Company? This is Hamilton G. Holland speaking. Yes. A couple of men who claim to be from your office are here to remove my furniture. Now, I should think you would apologize. And in the meantime, cancel that other order of mine.
Where are you going with that?
I'm taking it in. You know, it's been disconnected for 3 days.
Right, Joe.
cancel that other order of mine.
This is Mr. Holland's office.
Yeah, in there.
Hiya, Mr. Holland. What? Just take that right out, gentlemen. And be sure and bring me the kind of desk I ordered. I want a strictly modern desk. Something with a dash and a verve.
Sure, we'll bring you back one with walnut trimming.
And don't forget the glass top. I hope you'll forgive the condition of my offices. We're having them redecorated. Won't you come in and meet my associates? This is Mr. Van Norton, one of my graduates.
Charmed, Miss...
And Mrs. Bent. Mrs. Robert Bent.
And this is Mr. Biddleford, my scenario writer.
How do you do?
Delighted.
I saw your ad in the magazine.
Oh, the ad. So you decided to follow in the footsteps of Pickford, Swanson, Garbo, and May West?
Well, yes, that is I.
Exactly. Have you been in California long, Mrs. Ben?
Oh, no. We just arrived. My husband sold his business in Newark, and we've decided to settle here.
And a very wise decision. This is the land of opportunity. Won't you sit down, Mrs. Ben? Now, of course, about your picture possibilities. Of course, you understand we're only interested in pupils who possess exceptional qualifications.
Yes, that is fine.
What experience have you had, Mrs. Beck?
Well, you see,
Have you been on the stage?
Oh, yes. I played the lead in the charity show our bridge club gave, and, of course, in college,
Well, then, you're not unfamiliar with the traditions of the theater.
Oh, no.
But, gentlemen. My associates seem a little undecided, Mrs. Beth. So I suggest that we make a test under regular studio conditions. You don't object, do you, Mrs. Bent?
Oh, not at all, Mr. Holland. I only hope I'll make good.
Will you gentlemen see that everything is in readiness on the stage?
Well, certainly, Mr. Holland.
Thank you, sir. Of course, you understand that this will be simply a photographic test. Just to see whether or not you have that elusive something that is so necessary to motion picture greatness.
Oh, I hope so, Mr. Holland. I'll do my best.
Don't worry. I have a feeling everything will be all right.
Hey, where are you going with the camera?
I'm going to trade it in for a ham sandwich.
Oh, now, wait a minute, Joe. You got to help us out. Holland's got a live prospect, and he wants to give it a test build-up.
He's out of luck. We haven't any film.
Oh, we don't need any.
All yours is 2 weeks' salary now.
But I tell you, here's a chance to get your money. Holland has a sucker. I mean a client. Come on, ask Van.
All right. Are you sure this is real dough?
This is the real old-fashioned stuff.
What do you say, Joe?
What could we lose? All right. Come on now, boys. Get it all set up. Yeah.
We'll go. Come on.
Just be completely at ease, Mrs. Bent. I want you to feel perfectly at home. Just relax. Mrs. Bent, would you mind standing for just a moment while we make a few adjustments? Is this position all right for you, Joe? I want Mrs. Bent to have every assistance we can give her for this very important test.
That's about right.
Splendid. Now, if you just relax, Mrs. Bent, while we arrange the lights. Take it easy, Mrs. Ben, but give it all you've got. The camera ready?
Okay.
All right, camera. Now, Mrs. Ben, turn your head slowly to the right. Now, to the left, slowly. Way around, we want to get both profiles. That's it. Now, face the camera, smile. No, you're happy. That's it. Now you look just a little to your right. see him wave. You see a woman with him. You're jealous. You're angry. You're very angry. You feel as though you could kill her. And suddenly you realize it's his arm.
They've turned the juice off on us.
Congratulations, Mrs. Bent. A perfect fade-out to a lovely scene. I'm sure the film will justify my reaction. I'm seldom mistaken.
Then you'll take me?
Walked into my office, I pinned my paper. You're progressing much faster than I'd even hoped. And since seeing your last test, I'm convinced that you're possessed of the divine fire. You're now ready to scale the heights.
Oh, Mr. Holland.
Hi, Mr. Holland.
Is that all for you?
Hi, Mr. Holland.
I suppose so. But I prefer to ignore business while we're at luncheon.
Why don't you answer this? It might be
important. Oh, boy. Hamilton G. Holland speaking.
All right. It's 12:30. Now, what am I supposed to say?
You know I never discuss business at this hour. He's certainly working hard on this one.
Boy, is she a lifesaver.
Very soon, I hope to see your name in electric lights. The star.
How much do you think
Fred
cost to make this picture?
Well, under careful supervision, which, of course, I shall bring, I should say it can be done for approximately 40,000. That's the amount that you're... that's the amount you said we could figure out, isn't it?
Yes.
When can I speak to your husband?
Well, I could bring him to the studio this afternoon.
Mom, you noticed the change in Helen the past 2 weeks?
Well, yes, I have.
Yeah? What have you noticed?
She's getting terribly extravagant, buying all those new clothes and doodads.
Are they the kind of clothes she'll be using on a farm? Not in a million years, they're not. Listen, Helen's been bitten by a bug. The motion picture bug. Yeah, that ain't all. The man after her.
You mean to say that Helen's been running around with another man?
No, not exactly a man. Listen, he's one of the slickest fakes in the motion picture business. If we don't do something about it, he'll be talking Helen into investing Bob's money.
Oh, you frighten me. That would be terrible.
Something's got to be done.
Hello there. Anybody home?
And done quick.
Buy it now before Helen gets home.
Oh, and I want Helen to see the pictures of it. Buy it first and make her like it afterwards. Hey, what are you
tell him off. Come on, out with it.
Oh, I hate to tell you.
Well, now, why all the mystery? What's happened around here?
Willie says that Helen's running around with another man.
How do you know?
I've seen him together dozens of times on a boulevard. His name is Holland and he's a fake and he's got a studio on Poverty Row. You better buy this farm before Helen gets your money away from you.
Hello there. Won't you come in?
If I come back, Mr. Bent, to find what you wanted this trip?
Oh, yes.
By the way, I saw your wife down on the boulevard a short while ago.
You did. Was she alone?
Yep. There's a man with her. A fine-looking fella. Where is this farm, Mr. Bent?
Huh? Oh, down in Picanto Valley. It's a nut farm.
Taking Willie with you? That's a good one, ain't it? Likely looking place. How many acres?
50.
Sure is.
Sure is what?
50. That's quite a house.
Yes, it's lovely.
Yes, she is. You think your wife will like it?
The nearest neighbor is 5 miles away.
Yeah, we won't be bothered with having people run in on us all the time.
The neighbors will have to drive over.
Yeah.
Is this something new?
Huh? Oh, yes. That's my wife's latest photograph.
Looks like your wife. She's pretty, ain't she? Ought to be in a movie.
Got something to be done about this.
I could speak to a friend of mine.
Thanks.
Oh, no trouble at all. Always glad to give advice about a farm. I know land from here to enter.
He can hear pretty well when you don't want him to.
Goodbye. Don't mind me. Little hard of hearing.
Bye, Mr. Sliscomb.
Bob, I hope you haven't offended Mr. Sliscomb. I wish you'd be more careful.
Careful? My wife's running around with another man, and you ask me to be careful.
Oh, Bob, she's up against a racket she doesn't know anything about.
Now, oh, shut up.
All right. Have it your own way.
But you better buy that farm.
Going to be rich. Rich, sweetheart. I've got talent. I've got what they call at the studio, the divine fire. Bob, I'm going to be a star. Think of it, a star. With one picture, we're going to triple our money. And look at these stills. Aren't they lovely? Isn't that nice? Oh, and Bob, they say at the studio, I'm so lucky to have Mr. Holland so interested in me. I'm an emotional find. Oh, Bob, I'm so happy. Aren't you?
No. I'm darned unhappy.
Why do you say that?
Because I mean it. What are you running around with this man Holland for?
What do you mean, running around with him?
Why, running around with him? Well, I've been looking for a home for us.
Why, Bob Bent, I never heard of such a thing. Oh.
Don't let the water work at you, Bob.
Say, I want this nonsense stopped. One moving picture nut in the family is enough. I happen to know this man Holland's reputation, and he's a crook. A Norris make-up woman would be seen on the street with him.
This is some of your doing. What have you been telling Bob?
I mean, but the truth, sister. Why, Holland will have Bob's money inside of a month. Then Bob will be broke. Broke in California. And if there's one state in the world worse than any other to go broken, it's California.
Come on over here. I want to show you some pictures. Oh, don't cry, honey. Come on, sit down. I want to show you something. Hey, look here. Here are the pictures of the farm I found.
You wouldn't even look at my pictures.
Why, yes, I did. Why, I thought they were beautiful.
Honestly?
Of course. Here's a picture of the house. Isn't that a beauty?
Well, where
grape?
Yes, I suppose so.
And we'll be independent for life. The owner showed me his figures for last year, and he cleared over $5,000.
Oh, but that's nothing compared to what Mr. Holland said I could make. But I suppose that's all over now.
Atta girl. See, we have time to close the deal this afternoon. What do you say?
All right. Oh, but I thought...
Gee, honey, we're going to be awfully happy up there in the mountains. Away from everybody.
Away from everybody?
Yeah. And at night, when the stars are out, why, it's so still, you can almost hear your heartbeat.
How far is it from Hollywood?
Oh, long way.
Is it near a railroad?
No. But sometimes when the wind's in the right direction, you can hear the train whistle. Way off.
Oh.
Oh, gee, honey. You're going to love this place. Way at night, after the sun is down, you can hear the wild animals howling.
Wild animals?
Oh, just the sort of place I've been dreaming of for years.
Oh. Well. You've always let me do what I wanted to before.
Well, I'd do it now if I thought it was the right thing to do. Of course, I never had a great opinion of Willie, but I think he knows what he's talking about this time.
Bob, the studio's only 5 minutes from here.
Yeah, but the real estate office closes in a...
Oh, but it's right on our way, Bob. And it'll only take us a few minutes to see the test. Bob, if they find out that we're not going to do the picture... They'll destroy the place. Oh, and I wanted so to have you see it.
Oh, no, please, honey. Don't coax me.
No. I wouldn't have you do anything you don't want to do.
Just because you look like a famous star doesn't even work for nothing.
Say, listen, what do you suppose I got this furniture and set the stage for? You'll get paid. Now, this client will be here any minute now. All I want is the old routine.
You'll get the old routine. I never did like this racket anyway, but a girl's got to live. All my talk about it after all...
I'll get my pay this time. Be the last time you see me around this joint.
I don't see how I can possibly do it for $100,000, but of course if Mr. Holland says so.
Oh, I certainly would take Mr. Holland's advice. You remember that extra $50,000 he got me on my last contract?
There's a chair, dear. Oh, pardon me.
Pardon me for staring, but there's something about you which reminds me of my sister.
Oh.
I go home.
Oh, now don't say that, Greta. We'll sign the contracts in the morning.
Oh.
Well, Mrs. Grant, I'm so sorry to have kept you waiting.
Oh, that's all right, Mr. Holland. I want you to know my husband. He's come to see my test.
How do you do, Mr. Beck? How do you do, Mr. Holland? Well, won't you come in?
Oh, thank you.
It'll take the operator a few minutes to get the film ready, and then we'll go into projection.
Oh, we had a few minutes, haven't we, Bob? Haven't we, Bob?
Huh? Oh, yes, yes.
Turning your head just a little more to the left, please.
There, you see what I mean?
Now that you've mentioned it, I do. It's remarkable.
See, what's all this about?
Mr. Bent, you're a very lucky man.
Why?
Didn't anyone ever tell you that you look like Adolph Marjorie? Wouldn't it be strange if your daughter inherited her talent? Beautiful. Beautiful. She reminds me of... Now, don't tell me.
Marion Davies.
That. Only your daughter's eyes have a deeper fire.
She takes a nice picture, doesn't she?
Mrs. Barton, your daughter is a very beautiful woman. I see a great resemblance.
Won't you sit down?
Thank you. I've just driven in to my farm. I'm a trifle tired.
Oh, you own a farm?
I own three. All purchased with a profit. A huge profit of the motion picture business.
Oh. You're the moving picture man?
Yes. Hamilton T. Holland. I see your daughter has been telling you about
it. No, my son has told me about you.
His name is...
Willie.
Of course, Willie Barton. Oh, you're a talented boy.
Huh?
He's destined to make a great name for himself. I've had my eye on him for some time.
Is that so?
Mrs. Barton, you should be a very proud woman. To be the mother of two such talented children.
But Willie tells me that you...
Your son doesn't understand me.
Being misunderstood is bitter misfortune of every great producer.
Dear, I wish Willie was here.
Oh, they won't listen to me. They think I'm a false alarm.
Willie, you must do something to stop them.
Or you'll think I'm a false alarm too, huh?
If you go away tonight without making one final effort, yes. Take me in your strong arms once more,
Eustace. What?
I didn't say anything. I'll be waiting here. Should you never return? I'll go on. Go on.
Willie, you can't go now.
That's right. If they think I'm a false alarm, wait till they see me in action.
Agatha, maybe Dad can help us.
That's an idea. He's a hard-headed businessman. Bring him along.
Goodbye, Eustace. Goodbye.
Who is this Eustace?
He's my lover in the picture.
He just left me. To ride across the burning desert.
A year rolled by.
And you're back in North.
No city. Cairo. I see the camels coming across the desert. I walk.
A mile.
Marty, you don't know the story. Mr. Biddleford said there's a smash at the end of it.
We bet there is for Bob and his 40,000.
No such thing. Why, the money Bob's going to make out of this picture?
You can put in a flea's eye.
Why are you so obstinate? Do you think you know more than Mr. Holland?
Yes.
I walk and walk.
And so, Mrs. Barton, I'm looking forward to making a lot of money. For all of
us. Yes.
And I feel...
Willie, what brought you back?
I changed my mind.
You know Mr. Holland.
Yeah, I know.
How do you do, Willie?
Have you seen Mrs. Smith?
Yes. She's out in the garden rehearsing her primitive emotions. I love you. I hate you. Take back your jewels. I scorn you, other man. I scorn your advances. I'm through. I'm through, I'm through, I'm through, I tell you. I don't know what I'm saying. Take me back. Take me back.
Willie, Barton, have you gone crazy?
Look out in the garden and get along with her.
Got to dress it.
I overheard
you talking to Dawn. That's lovely. Really? You ought to be ashamed of yourself making fun of your sister.
What has he told you to?
Willie doesn't realize that his sister possesses the divine.
And her husband possesses $40,000.
Willie, did you know that there was a great actress in Europe by the name of Barton?
What has that got to do with the noise in the garden?
Oh, how do you do, Mr. Holland?
How do you?
I hope you don't mind Willie's playfulness.
Not at all. Your mother and I were enjoying the performance.
Come on in, gentlemen.
Oh, how do you do, Mr. Biddeford?
How do you do, Mrs. Dent?
And Mr. Van Norton.
Good evening, Mrs. Dent. I met these gentlemen outside.
Did you bring the story, Mr. Biddeford?
Oh, yes, indeed, Mrs. Dent.
Mother dear, I want you to meet Mr. Biddeford, the author.
How do you do?
And Mr. Van Norton, my leading man.
Oh, so you're back, eh?
Yes, Mother.
I didn't think you had the gumption to go through with it.
That remains to be seen.
Now I want you all to be quite comfortable. Mr. Biddleford, you sit right here, please.
Thank you.
Where the light will fall over your shoulders.
Maybe it would be better if it would fall on his head.
Oh, no. No, it's much better over the shoulder. And Mr. Van Norton.
Well, if you don't mind, I'll just sit over here.
Oh, all right. And Mother, will you sit here next to Mr. Biddleford, please? And Mr. Holland. Next to my mother, please.
Thanks.
Oh,
now.
The action begins in a small country village.
Oh, Mother, will you answer that, please?
Oh, how do you do, Mr. Sliscomb?
Hello, Agatha. Come right in.
Thank you.
This is Mr. Norton, Helen's leading man. This is Mr. Sliscomb and his daughter, Agatha. Mr. Sliscomb's our landlord. He owns this bungalow court.
Play actor picture. Oh. Honey, I never seen one before.
The floor. And this is Mr. Biddleford.
How do you do?
Mr. Biddleford's an officer. And this is Mr. Holland.
Well, come right in, sir. We're very glad to have you.
Thank you. We're just about to hear Helen's new play.
Well, we've got the time.
I think we're ready to proceed, don't you?
Yes, let's see.
The action begins in a small country village.
Huh?
It is about 7 of a bright spring morning. The village lads are driving the cows to the factory.
What time do you say?
About 7 in the morning.
Why?
To make their cows go through the yard. 4 o'clock in the morning is the time we drive cows to pasture. Is that so, Mr. Holland?
Well, of course. Change the time to 4 o'clock.
Oh, all right.
Begin again, Mr. Biddleford.
It is about 7 in the morning.
There's another thing. Village lads don't drive cows to pasture. It's country boys.
Of course.
What's the matter with you, Biddleford?
I'll change the first seat. After the cows are in the pasture, Eustace, that's the hero. Big smart. Molly carries a tail on her arm. She's on her way to pick wild blackberries.
Pick what?
Wild blackberries. In the spring?
Better make it in August.
It has to be in the spring.
Then cut out the blackberries. Make it dandelion green.
Or spinach.
Nice dandelion green to help it. Blackberries give you a bellyache.
Mr. Christian, we're going to begin again. Please be quiet.
That fellow's got hay fever.
I have not got hay fever. That's what I said, mister. Hay fever.
Hold it. Can I get you a little spirits of ammonia?
Oh, not pneumonia. Hay fever.
It's not hay. Hey,
you don't hide. That goldenrod does that.
Well, let's remove it.
From the beginning.
Well, the action begins in a small country village. It is about 10. And the 4 of a bright spring morning. The village, I mean the country boys, are driving the cows to the pasture. And across the desert.
Oh, wow. I'm not a bit scared, but you've been over an hour reading.
Up the cattle.
What?
The cattle. The cattle.
Camels.
Camels. Carries the foreign leech to the rescue. Then he takes her in his arms and he fades out.
Well, now, that's a right pretty story. How much did you say this picture was the cost?
$40,000.
Make a better one for 50?
You're the type of hard-boiled businessman I like to meet. Why, for $10,000 more, we can make this not merely a picture, but an epic.
Epic?
Good idea.
Here, Holland. This is to be my proposition.
Now, I just thought I'd like to be in on it.
Of course.
If you object, oh, gentlemen, please, I'm sure we can make a satisfactory agreement. Now, for $40,000, we're assured of a comfortable profit.
What if, by Mr. Sliscomb, simply investing $10,000 more, we can double our own profit?
Good business seems to say do it.
Yes. Sounds reasonable.
Then, gentlemen, I'll just change this contract to read 40% to you, and 15% to Mr. Sliscomb, and
5% to the Holland production. Perhaps the gentleman would just initial the exchanges.
Yes, sir.
You're not going to go through with this. Oh, Mrs. Sliscomb, you ought to know better. Agatha will tell you.
Yes, Dad.
Now, honey, you just keep out of it. Bob, you're not going to throw your money away like this, are you?
Just a moment, Dad. I have a very pleasant surprise that I've been saving until the signing of this contract. Now, as you know, a great deal of the success of the picture will depend upon the director. Well, I've had a certain young man under observation for quite some time. And I am very happy to announce that I have chosen for this very important position none other than my very good friend, Willie Barton.
You mean that?
Absolutely.
Put it in the contract.
Some people around here.
Where's the Foreign Legion? Where's the Bedouins?
They're not here yet, sir.
Why?
Holland wants to see you in his office.
All right, hold everything. Look here, Chief, I got a big set. Where are all the people? What's wrong?
I'm sorry, but I don't think we're going to shoot that set.
Not shoot it, why? It's the big kick of the picture. What's the matter?
Keep my strength. We're just a little short.
What do you mean?
I mean, the bankroll
is
no more.
Oh, so that's it. You almost had me fooled. I thought maybe you were going to give Bob and Sliscomb a run for their money.
Willie, you misjudged me. Why, I have figures here to show that every cent of the $50,000 has been spent legitimately.
Yeah, I know. $2,500 for a story?
No, Willie. No, $5,000 for a story.
That's citizen.
$5,000 for supervision.
That's you?
Correct. $5,000 for a box office name.
That's Van Norton.
$15,000 for studio rental, $10,000 for sets, $6,000 for labor, and the balance, interest?
That's me.
Well, in a way, no. So I felt that you'd be amply repaid by this marvelous opportunity.
Marvelous opportunity to discover how big a crook you are. Why, you never intended to finish this picture. You were just going to take a couple of chunks for a buggy ride, but you made one mistake, Mr. Holland. You thought I was a mug.
Really? Can it be possible I was wrong?
I'll bet you had a lot of laughs letting me direct this picture. Think I'm like you're crazy.
My fault.
I'll use it. Hello, Bob. That's a mob. Get a hold of Bob and come down to see you right away. And get Sliscomb and Agatha, if she'll come. I can't explain now, Mother. Get down here right away. Hurry. All right, Mr. Flicker. Come out and sit and watch my smoke. I was engaged to direct this picture, and I'm going to finish it in spite of you and your incident.
Good luck. The cruise time is up at 5 o'clock.
That's long enough for me, and from now on, you keep out of my way. One of these days, Mr. Holland, you're going to have the pleasure of rubbing your big nose up against my fist.
What a determined young man.
Folks, we only have a few hours to make this scene, but I've explained it to you, so it's up to you. Now, you all remember where Eustace and Molly are fleeing across the desert, pursued by the Bedouin.
Yes.
The Foreign Legion comes to the rescue.
Yes, I remember, Mr. Biddleford, reading that.
That's it, Mom, except we have no Bedouins and no Foreign Legion. I'm sure if you people all help me out, we can get along without it.
What do you say?
Yes, of course.
Well, we'll do the best we can. Van Norton, you and Helen enter over that sand dune there.
All right.
Mom, you and Sliscomb, you be the Foreign Legion. Now, you stand right over here. Over here, Mom. That's what. Oh, Mr. Sliscomb, you know the kind of a noise a camel makes when he runs? No, but I can do a pretty good horse. All right, let me hear your horse run. In the mud? Anywhere, in the sand, in the desert.
How about you, Mom?
You mean like this?
Ah, that's great, Mama. Let me hear them both together. Ah, the Foreign Legion! Eustace? Oh, boys, off the set. Give your director a break, will you? You and Molly, you're all in. You look back. You see the Bedouins coming. Oh, that.
forgotten it.
We're all set to go, and you forget your speech. The better ones are coming. I've got to kill you, darling, you mug. All right, come on, once again. All right, you see him?
The better ones are coming. I've got to kill you, darling, you mug.
No, no, you're a mug. Don't say it. Oh, it's bad than Molly when he says that. Be brutal to her, Eustace. No, no, be brutal. Brutal! Put you to her knees. Hang out your saber. Molly. Molly, bare your throat. No, 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 not too much. She'll teach little children to steal. Then the choir leader comes galloping on. All right, let's go. Get ready. How's that for sound?
Okay, a little stronger on the better ones.
Let's make it. Camera's all set. Sound ready? Light. This is the picture.
Quiet, everybody. This is the picture.
Something in this climate that makes fools out of sensible people.
She's gone.
Who's gone?
Agatha. She's been out all night and gone all day. And it's Willie's fault. And if I don't fill his back full of buckshot, it's my fault.
Well, why blame Willie?
Her bed ain't been slept in.
Well, what's Willie got to do with that? If your girl went away with my Willie, that's her fault.
Now, don't take it so hard. Try and be calm.
Everybody's picking on Willie. If you'd bought that bomb, we wouldn't be in all this trouble.
Have you heard anything about the picture?
No.
But, Bob...
Now, don't worry. We'll pull out all right.
Darling, you'd be so sweet. you haven't said an unkind word to me.
No, and I'm not going to. We'll start all over again. By the way, dear, I'll have to borrow your bracelets.
What?
Rope. I'm a little in debt. I'll have to sell them to pay our fare to Norton.
Oh, Bob.
Much left, have I?
No. But you're acquiring 45% of the picture through that bill of sale.
I certainly appreciate this, Mr. Holland.
All I call it good business.
I hope you're right.
Gentlemen, you have just seen a marvelous specimen of the American mammal.
Here to make you a proposition.
If you and your gang think you're going to get any more money out of me, you're crazy.
I'm broke. Oh, I'm not here to get any money from you. I'm here to give you some.
What?
I've decided to stand part of your loss.
Oh, I should have known better than to let Willie direct that picture.
Don't mention his name to me again.
Sit down, Mr. Now, you lost $40,000.
and I feel obligated to stand by Sheriff. I have here a certified check for $10,000.
$10,000? For me?
Right. And just to keep everything on a business basis, would you mind signing this?
I'm here to stand this. You're willing to take my share of the picture off my hands for $10,000. Are you sure you can afford it?
I guess it won't cripple me. Besides, it relieves my conscience.
That's a funny thing. I've been over to the studio all day looking for you. Blood in my eye, too. Now you've come here of your own accord and offer me $10,000.
I suppose with your knowledge of the business, you'll be able to salvage something.
Not a cent, Mr. Bennett.
A cent?
Take the money.
But Mr. Bent, I...
No, it wouldn't be right.
But if I'm willing to...
Now, see here, I rented in this thing with my eyes open. It's up to me to take my medicine. Now, if Willie'd known anything about directing, we'd have made money. Now, that's true, isn't it?
Yes, of course, he burned us. But I want to do the right thing by you, Mr. Bent. You know that, don't you?
Yes, but...
Then no buts about it. You sit down, sign that contract, and take that money.
Well, how about Mr. Sliscomb?
I'll take care of Mr. Sliscomb just as soon as our business is completed.
In that case, of course.
Oh, I didn't know we had company.
How do you do, Mrs. Bennett?
Stay in the grave, honey. Mr. Holland is going to buy my share of the picture for $10,000.
$10,000?
Yes, I thought it only fair.
Well, I'll say it's fair.
Oh, there's a bottle of it right in the kitchen. I'll get it. Hello?
Should have held out for 750 a week. 250 ain't enough.